Glory to God. And Brother Tim will receive the offering tonight. And momentarily, we'll be going into 2 Corinthians chapter 4, picking up where we left off long ago, as far as Wednesday nights. So good to see all of you tonight. Amen. I really feel wonderful being here. God bless you. Let's take a moment and we'll pray for the offering. Father in heaven, we thank thee for this offering thou hast brought forth, and we give it unto thee cheerfully to thy work. Let it be blessed of thee and used of thee, O God, to the glory of thy name. Help us to reach out to the lost quickly, because time is short. And Lord, let thy blessing be upon us now as we go into thy word. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I just wanted to say that I really appreciate all of you very much. And I just want to thank God that he's given me the ability to get up here again and continue to teach, because it's my whole life.
Amen.
And I've known some of you for a very long time, some of you not quite so long, but I believe that God has put us together as a congregation, and we are in the last days, and we're family here. We're not, we're close to each other, and we're in the Spirit, and I do feel the love of Jesus Christ here tonight.
Amen.
Here I am, kind of beat up yet. I'm still not recovered. It's taking a while. That's all right. The Lord is showing me things. And every time I get up here, I have to pray during the day, Lord, give me a miracle so I can get up there and teach, because I need to have great presence of mind. And then I pray that thou wouldst anoint me to help me to get thy word out. I know I've studied, I've preached, I've taught for 40 years now. And yeah, that's about right, 40 years. I was, God filled me with the Holy Ghost on May 11th of 1969. But anyway, that's a long time ago, isn't it?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. But he's finally got things, I believe, right where he wants them. And everything that's happened to me, I believe, is for a reason. And so I'm glad to be here tonight. And I'm glad to know that God is in charge, and that we're all friends, brothers, sisters. We all love God.
Amen.
I look back at you, I see the love of God in you. Some of you old, if you don't mind me using that, it's an honor to be old and still serving God.
Yes.
You know, I'm not a young man anymore either. I'll be 60 years old in a couple of weeks on June 5th. And I look back like at Gordon and Darlene. I love those dear people. Here they are later in their later years serving God, loving God. And they're an inspiration to me. I sometimes think of them when I need to feel an inspiration. I look at all of you, the others, you all have your place, and how God uses you. And I could name any one of you here and tell about how thankful I am just to know you, just to be your friend. And I want to be the best friend you could ever have.
Yes.
So I want to say I appreciate Vicki Wolf very much for taking on extra duties for me. I had always been so careful and diligent to try to run things properly, administratively. Unfortunately, in any enterprise in this world, you have business things to take care of, and I was so wrapped up in all of that so much. And the Lord just really knocked me down and got me to the point where I had to give it up. All I want to do now And I've told the Lord this over and over and over again. All I want to do now is minister in the word and in prayer.
Yes.
In prophetic ministry, and no more administrative, no more of the things that go along with, you know, from the business standpoint. I just don't want anything to do with that anymore, because the Lord has taken that away from me. He's made it very difficult for me to read and that's all right, because I can still read his word. I have no trouble with that. I'll save what ability I have, I'll save for the word. So keep me in prayer, because I think we're moving into a great new era. And the Lord is coming soon. He's getting us ready. But I appreciate all of you so much. I feel like I've got the best congregation in the whole world. I'm certainly not worthy of it, but I'm going to work hard. So anyway, keep me in prayer, really. It's sustaining me. Things are looking better. And I got a report back yesterday that my kidneys are working more efficiently again. The number has greatly changed in just a week. And the other numbers also are slowly getting better. So my foot was looked at yesterday. It was completely healed.
Wow. Amen. Praise God.
Shirley said she was amazed by it. It just, the doctor looked at it, his face kind of, he got this big surprised look on his face and said, "This is all dry, this is healed."
Amen.
So the Lord is with me, and he's with me in my infirmities. Now, I wanted to mention too regarding Pal Talk, I'm going to try and do this tomorrow night. I'm going to have the boys come over and to my house, and we're going to broadcast from there. That way I won't have to go out again. It is kind of difficult for me. This weather is hard for me right now, because I'm trying to get well, and it's just so cold outside. So I'm praying for better weather too. But we will plan to have Pal Talk tomorrow night, and we're reaching a lot of people through the computer that way. So keep all of our efforts in prayer, and God bless you. We're going to go into the Word now. And first I'd like to pray. Dear Father in heaven, Lord, we feel thy love. We feel thy goodness, thy grace, thy mercy. We thank thee, O God, this night that we can study thy Word together, because there's such power in thy Word to prepare our hearts, to change us, to remake us, to draw us close to thee. Lord, we feel the drawing power of thy Spirit. Let the power of the Holy Ghost, O God, come in right now and draw us ever closer to thee. We know the time is at hand, that the world is in chaos and strife, but in thy kingdom is peace. Help us, Lord, now as we study thy word, that we might learn of thee tonight. And we ask it in Jesus' name. Let Satan be driven out. Let him have no power to interfere. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's just give the Lord a hand praise. Amen. All right. We are in 2 Corinthians chapter 4. The Apostle Paul is writing this letter to the Corinthians, and there's so much in here that they need to know, that we need to know. He starts out by saying, "Therefore, seeing we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we faint not, but have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty."